And that means it's time, as we always do each week on a Tuesday and a Wednesday, at around this time, to give you the chance to tell us about the music that you love and why, the albums that mean the most to you. Tell us about your musical passion and stories behind the tracks to your life. That's it's a little play on Stevie Wonder's Songs in the Key of Life. We're calling it Songs in the Key of Your Life. See what we did there? Very clever. And you can be involved as well. Email the show, stephen.brown@bbc.co.uk. I've said it once, I'll say it again. Stephen is my name, with a P and an H, please and thanks. So today we're going to hear from another listener. This is Pete in Woking.
Hi, my name is Pete. I'm from Woking in Surrey, and the album I'm choosing, my favourite of all time, pretty much, is Declaration by The Alarm. 68 guns, you'll never die. 68 guns, our battle cry. 68... It was September 1984. I was age 14 when I first heard their classic single 68 Guns on breakfast TV before I went off to school. What an anthem! Still moves me to this day. The second time I actually heard it back then was on Top of the Pops. Coupled with the spiky hair and cowboy image made a long-lasting impression on me. I could identify with the themes they sung about, anti-war, standing up for yourself, and what you believe in, that kind of thing. Pick of the album, if I had to pick, Blaze of Glory. I remember this much, there is nothing to choose, speak up if you've got something to say. It was actually written because U2 and The Alarm toured together about literally 40-odd years ago. And Bono was getting really criticised by the press for like sort of bearing his soul on stage kind of thing and just singing it from the heart. And Blaze of Glory was written about Bono. And it's funny how they shoot you down when your hands are held up high. And everyone would have that, the arms in the air, all that. It's still played now, and the fans still do the same thing. But it's a real, like, you know, standing up for what you believe in kind of song. So... perfect album, absolute perfect album. My first ever gig of The Alarm was age 16 in May 1985 on the final of their absolute tour at the Guildford Civic Hall. When the band came on stage, I can distinctly recall being covered in goosebumps despite it being really hot and sweaty in there. I was completely blown away and hooked by the band's passion, tunes and presence. They were absolutely on fire, as in, like, you know, really going for it. And they just absolutely blew me away. I just remember that feeling. I think, wow, you know, I remember it being really hot and sweaty. But I was getting goosebumps right up and down my arms. It's like, how, you know, it's a bit odd feeling that. And, you know, not many bands can do that, or things can do that to you, really, or to me anyway, but music generally. It was just an amazing experience. It's £4 to get in as well. £4! Since that day in 1985, I've actually lost count the amount of times I've seen The Alarm play, literally hundreds of times. For over the years, I've got to know the band, especially the former bassist Eddie, who I can actually call a mate these days. I wouldn't have believed that as a teenager. Let's lift our voices higher, let's sing our song. Keep on marching, marching, and never forget about the power. Before The Alarm were around, I was into just like the chart music of the time. I mean, I still love some of that even now, but it was very cheesy and, you know, Wham and Duran Duran, which I still love, actually, ironically, but that was just like the norm. I didn't know any different until bang, one day, this just before leaving for school. Do you want to hear something really ironic? As I said, it's the anniversary of the album. This morning, knock on the door, a postman with a reissue copy of the album, which Mike Peters has put out as an anniversary issue. So, I mean, this in front of me here, I've got the original album here from 1984, and as of this morning, I've got, it's called Alternative Declaration. It's basically, it's a different mix of the album. Well, I haven't even played it yet. So it's kind of ironic, I'm doing this chat about this album, and the album comes through the post again today. And the album was released February 1984, 40 years since it was first released, and it just sounds as fresh and as timeless as it did back then. And lastly, big shout out to my lifelong friends I met along the way through The Alarm. Love to Matt, Paris, Pat, Lorenzo, Darren, Dave, Adi, Paul, Alison, and so many others.
That's Pete telling us about his love of The Alarm and an album of choice. So there we go. You can get involved with Songs in the Key of Your Life as well. If you want to, give us a call or email stephen.brown@bbc.co.uk.